Hey everybody, and welcome back to another video. In this one, I'm going to be quickly going over everything that you need to know about trading in Lumber Tycoon 2. I'm going to be going over how you can find a trade, how to conduct a safe trade, and even some good trading values for how much you should sell and buy items for. So without further ado, let's just get right into how to find a good trade, and I have two main strategies to do this. The first strategy here is going to involve Discord, so if you do have a Discord account, this strategy I definitely recommend using. If you do not, skip ahead to the next one. Lumber Tycoon 2 has many big Discord servers where you can list and buy items in a marketplace along with work, auctions, and just other things in general. Of all the marketplaces, the best ones are definitely the Lumber Tycoon 2 wiki and Apton server. In the Lumber Tycoon 2 wiki, there are thousands of posts that you can go through, and you can talk with a ton of people who are also wanting to trade. Setting up a post in either of the servers is very easy also, as all you need to do is go up here, write in what you're selling, and then create it over here. So yeah, I highly recommend using Discord to trade in Lumber Tycoon 2, because without Discord, you're gonna have to resort to my next option, which is a lot slower, but can also be useful. Okay guys, so the next option is pretty basic, it's just server hopping until you find a trade, but there are some things that you can do to make this process a lot more easy for you. More easy is just easier, I should have just said easier for you. Okay guys, so for server hopping, it's pretty basic, there are two ways to do it. I recommend this way, which is getting the RoPro extension and using this button here, as its server hop is pretty good. But if not, you can always just press the play button, although do be aware that when you press the play button, it's going to put you in a server with friends and servers that you've been in recently. So if you just hit the play button, you're likely going to end up in a server that you've already checked or a server that doesn't have anyone to trade with because your friend is already in there. That being said, the play button can be useful if you have no friends online and it's pretty empty, so I recommend just doing the play button when you have no one online. But the more reliable way to do it is to scroll all the way down to the bottom here where you can actually see all of the servers. And if you have plugins like I do, as you see, I can exclude the full servers and sort them. Actually, I think this is just a default thing. Anyways, I recommend just clicking the exclude full servers button, loading a few servers, and then highlighting the server like this, and then joining it. And once in the server, you're gonna check around and... I feel like this shouldn't be here. Anyways, as I was saying, you're gonna check around the map, see if you see anyone with a large pile of items or a lot of money, and this server we have neither, so that means all you gotta do is leave. And then come back over to your server list, highlight the next server, press join, repeat this process until you find someone. So in this server here, I see someone with a lot of money, and it looks like that's their base, they might have some stuff on it, so let's just go and check it out. So it looks like this player has some axes, but doesn't seem to have a shop, so it's worth just asking the player. Oh, they're blacklisted. And when you do this, I recommend only waiting about a minute or so, because if no one replies to you in like a minute, it's not worth it, just go to the next server. So yeah, like I said before, this method is a lot less efficient than just going on Discord, but if for some reason you can't access Discord, it's always a good method just to server hop, especially in times like Halloween when you server hop anyways for spook trees, you might as well just go and talk to some of the players. Anyways, with that out of the way, let's get into how to actually conduct a safe trade. So once again, I have two methods for how to conduct a safe trade. One of them is a lot more efficient, and the other one is not, but it's a lot safer. But let's just hop into the first method right now, and then we'll go over the second one after. So let's suppose that I want to buy an axe from my alt account over here, because I see some axes over there, and let's just say my alt is selling them. So in this scenario, I'm going to be buying this candy corn axe from my alt account here, and the safest way to do this is as follows. Step 1 is to ask the seller of the item to take the item and actually put it inside of your base. Now once the item is in the section of my base, so like just a few studs away, what I want to do is go here and blacklist the seller. And you can do that just by shutting off your visits from anyone. Now from the seller's point of view, they can't actually get into your base or receive their axe back. However, you can't receive the axe either, as it's still whitelisted to them. And what this does is it puts the item in a stasis, as I can't get the item, and the owner of the item can't get the item until we finish the trade. And to do that, obviously, you send your money to whoever the seller is, the agreed upon amount, let's just say it's $1. And once a seller has received the item, they can simply go into the settings menu and turn on save items to base for whoever they are selling to. And keep in mind that at this point, if the seller doesn't give you the item, they can't get it back. So you're just gonna have to sit here with the item and it'll be super awkward for the seller. Anyways, once you've gave the money to the seller and they have turned on the save to base permission, all you have to do is reload your slot. And just like that, the item is now yours. So whether you're the buyer or the seller of an item, I highly recommend this method as it is pretty secure and the chances of them scamming you using this method are pretty low, as if they do scam you, they're still gonna lose their item. Now the second option to conduct a safe trade is using a middleman. And the middleman is going to be another user whose job is to take the items and or money from both the buyer and the seller and save it to their base first. From there, the middleman has to give out the items and the money to whoever bought the item and whoever sold the item so that it's all fair. Using a middleman is almost 100% reliable as long as the middleman is trustworthy. However, if the middleman is not trustworthy, they can technically scam both the buyer and the seller, which is not a good thing. But if you're conducting a large trade, I do recommend using the middleman strategy with someone who both the buyer and the seller are comfortable with. And now we arrive at the last part of the video, which is good trading values. Now before I start this section, I want to preface it by saying that in reality, Lumber Tycoon 2 items hold pretty much no value. See, Lumber Tycoon 2 has a post-scarcity society slash economy, and basically what that means is that there's a ton of items, an easy way to make more of those items by things like duping, and not really a need for most of those items. And this means that ultimately, items can only sell for how much the buyer is willing to pay for, and there really isn't a set price for every item in the game. However, there are some generalizations that you can make. For example, if you have an item from an older year, such as 2015, it's obviously going to be worth more than an item from like 2022, just because of how old it is. And the same can be said with the cost of an item, as the more the item costs in the store, the more you should be able to sell on it in the actual market. Unfortunately though, it is often not the case that higher priced items sell for more in the market, just because of duping and how easy it is to recreate items that cost a lot of money, and then sell them for basically no money. So that's why when making trades, I recommend just completely factoring out the initial purchasing cost of the item, and just focus on how old the item is, and how useful it is to you, hence how much you want it. Something like an eye is going to be a lot more useful to you and it's someone else who's trying to buy it, than like a candy cane. So yeah, that's just my two cents on some good trading values. There are some lists that people have made of rough item values, but I'm not going to post any of them right now because, as I said, nothing in Lumber Tycoon 2 really holds a definitive value. Anyways, that's going to be it for this section and the video as a whole. Again, this was just a super quick guide explaining some of the most basic aspects of trading. There's a lot more in-depth ways to think about it, and there's also a lot of money to be made if you are really good at trading and want to get a lot of money in Lumber Tycoon. But nevertheless, I hope this guide helped you out somewhat, and I hope you can take something away from it. But without further ado, this is going to be it for me. Goodbye!